got your face. You got the shoes that I got, the clothes that I rock. Now what can you say with that look on your face? I'ma go hard, go hard, go hard.
Now look at your face.
I'ma go hard, go hard, go hard.
Now look at your face.
This summer smoke, I think the game needs a ventilator. I'm really looking to cop, you niggas speculators. I regulate with regulators, I'll check you later. Just gave a check, gotta connect that a detonation. I'm serious, just like a cardiac. As long as I'm alive, the south is where the party's at. So much liquor's like I'm spinning where the laundry at. I got a number weeks ago and I ain't call her back. I know she bitch, she had a chance to fulfill her dreams. Watch her as I pull up in a dick or reach a spleen. Certified nigga right here. My watch looking like a million light years. And I ain't stopping, you can't stop me. You can't knock me down, this ain't boxing. Manny Pacquiao, if you try and box me, your lames ain't shit without me. Look at the moves that I make, the holes that I take, the lick that I taste.
Yeah, man. Being dedicated is like that's all that I'm about. I'm a firm believer in the concept of following your dreams. You know, think about being dedicated and think about following your dreams and trying to be successful. Is that no matter what, there's nobody out there that can take it from you. And you know, I just feel like that's one of the most important things we as people strive for. You know what I'm saying? As far as dedication go, you dedicate to work, you know, 24/7, take it as a serious grind, you should be alright. Me personally, I'm in the studio as much as I can be. You know, I'm putting in work, you know, 30, 40, 50 hours a week. You know what I'm saying? So it's almost like a job. To tell you the truth, it's almost like a job to me. And you know, when I'm in here working on production, I'm in here working on songs, marketing plans, on graphics, everything. And, you know, to slack for a day or to slack for a couple of days, already behind schedule. So I believe that, you know, you work as hard as you can, and you devote as much time as possible to your dreams, then everyone's dreams is achievable. And, you know, that's going to guarantee you the best rate at being successful. The music game. The music game is real. How do I say? It's real. The music game is real territorial. It's 100% competition. The great thing about the music game is that I love making music because of the competition. You know what I mean? It's not that I'm only competing against myself when I'm working on the records. You know, trying to outdo my last song or outdo my last beat or whatever. You know what I'm saying? But I'm also competing with artists worldwide. You know, straight up. Like, I don't really care if you some unknown 15-year-old kid records in the bedroom. I don't care if you got multi-platinum plaques, Grammys, and all that. As an artist, as someone who makes music, as a producer, I'm literally coming for your head, straight up. So, you know, and it's I mean, the fans, you know, I think the fans enjoy that. I think the listeners out there, they enjoy good music. They enjoy people competing as far as getting their music out there. You know. And I think it just makes it good for the consumer out there, for the listener. So, you know, as long as it's good music, I'm competing with you, and I feel like the music game deserves that, and that's what I'm here for. That's what I'm here for. Man, it's been a minute since I dropped an actual K-OTIC release project, you know what I'm saying, and in all honesty, the last few years I've been producing for other artists, making beats for other artists, been networking with people on, you know, on Twitter, on Facebook, and whatnot, YouTube. Basically, I've been positioning myself, you know, making sure I enhance my brand, making sure I get my image out there, making sure that, you know, people become familiar with me as a producer. But in all honesty, you know, right now, everybody wants to hear me rap. And that's actually the inspiration for Conquer. So, you know what I'm saying? Like, Conquer is basically for those, you know what I'm saying? Whether you know me personally or not, whether you just know me through my music, it's basically for those who say, yo, when you gonna drop something? You feel what I'm saying? And, you know, if you like banging the beats, if you like, you know, real raps, if you like real lyrics, if you like bars, wordplay, all that shit, you know, Conquer's definitely for you. In all honesty, I think it's gonna be a favorite for all of my supporters and hip hop fans out there. You know what I'm saying? If you like to have a good time, Conquer's for you. If you like, I don't know, if you like your trunk to rattle when you listen to beats and to songs, you know, I got two 12s in the trunk, so my shit got it, man. You feel me? So if you like your trunk to rattle, Conquer's definitely for you. If you like to be chill and mellow out, just vibe, Conquer's for you. The whole album from top to bottom has that it's my world and I'm number one. Has that feel to it, like you on top of the world feel. That's why it's called Conquer, you know what I'm saying? I think it's gonna get good reception. I think a lot of ears are gonna be receptive to it. And, you know, looking forward to when it drops. December 27th is the date. And, you know, stay tuned. Stay tuned, Conquer.